The story of a dream run from a 2 rupee stock in year 2000, Balakrishna Industries has surged all the way to 2500 now. It's the second largest tire maker in India by market cap. What is driving the momentum? Darshan Mehta has analyzed this stock. And first of all, Darshan, tell us about Balakrishna Industries, this entire journey, which looks like a dream, you know.
Hey, it is. Just look at that. In 2000, it was trading at 2 rupees. I was also surprised when I was doing the analysis. And then it was pretty flat. And the real run started, you know, pretty much in 2011 and 12. And then it's just one way. And majority of the move has actually come in the last 3 years. So from being at levels of almost, it was 1,000 year, it's almost 2,500. So it's a dream run as far as Balakrishna Industries is concerned. Now, basically, the company is into off-highway tires. Look at the market cap. You'd be surprised that, you know, no one a few years ago considered bulk, no one even knew that it was a tire maker, and now it is the second largest market cap company in the tire space, right after MRF. It's almost gone past Apollo, C8 and JK Tires. TVS Shri Chakra is a smaller one, but clearly a phenomenal addition as far as market cap is concerned for Balakrishna Industries. Now it's trading, the move has been so violent, it's been so fast that it has surpassed all the brokerage targets also. So HSBC has a target price of 2200, Nirmal Bang has a target price of 2100, almost 2200, 2150. But the last few days move that has happened in Balakrishna Industries has taken all of that, and it is trading much above the Bloomberg consensus target also. So it's almost 18%, it's trading 18% higher than the consensus Bloomberg target. So that's the view that's happening as far as the Balakrishna Industries is concerned. Basically, just to give a scenario, as far as revenue is concerned, 72% of the revenue comes in from the replacement market, 26% from the original equipment, and as far as the markets are concerned, 80% of their revenues is from export and 20% is from the domestic market. So this is what Balakrishna. Very good return ratios, 12% on asset on equity, it is 22% and 15% on capital. So basically this is the scene as far as Balakrishna Industries, what the company does.
No, but Darshan, what sets Balakrishna Industries apart from its peers?
Yeah, so let's do a comparison as far as peers is concerned. First of all, just take a look at the revenues. It has managed to grow significantly. This is the debt profile. One of the most important factors, from a debt of almost 2,300 crores in the last quarter where they reported in the balance sheet, is just down to 702 crores. So they have managed to get down the debt significantly. On the cash basis, it's actually very close to becoming a net debt-free company. Apart from it, look at the peer comparison. As far as revenues are concerned, much lower than the peers. Even the profits, not the best, but look at the margin. This is what differentiates Balakrishna Industries. When everyone is struggling with 14 to 15% MRF, the largest one has managed to reach 20%. Balakrishna has been clocking consistently between the 25 to 35% mark. So this is very strong margin number that's come in. No doubt it is very, very expensive. Look at the PE at 23 times. MRF is at 15 times. At one time, MRF was trading sub 6%, sub 5%, sub 7 to 8%. And look at the valuation that happened. Even on an EV to EBITDA basis, where it is much more expensive. So valuations certainly are rich for Balakrishna Industries, but they are getting the valuation for the high margins that they are clocking in. Apart from it, let's also look at how their growth rate has been. From a revenue of almost 3,700 crores, the revenue has been consistent, but the first half has done extremely well. So probably they will crock more than 4,000 crores of revenue, and typically the second half is much more stronger. And the margins also, the first quarter was rather weak for them, but the second quarter they are expected to pick up. So margins are actually improving from 19% to 30%, and in the first half they have done 25%, but much ahead of what the street does. So this is the revenue picture as far. Now, what works for Balakrishna Industries? There are a couple of factors. High margin niche segment of highway tires, the margins are extremely strong. There is actually a lot of companies do that. Demand for agri and mining sectors are showing up. There was this note by HSBC where they expect the demand to pull up for these, and these are the basically customers. So Caterpillar was one of the new customers. No near-term capex. Most of the capex has done, and that will turn the company to net cash positive. They are already almost net debt positive, so that will be a cash positive company. The other factors you have to watch out for: rubber prices are down 40% from the recent high, so this will benefit the entire sector as such, but it will also benefit Balakrishna Industries. Local manufacturing gives them a big cost advantage because they export to a lot to Europe, and with the euro appreciating significantly against the rupee, that's a double advantage for Balakrishna Industries. Now, there are some risks. Obviously, valuations are extremely high, but there are a couple of risks. Rubber prices, if they inch up, the margins may take a hit, and that is applicable for the entire industry. Valuations, most expensive tire company in India at this point of time, and geopolitical risk. 80% of their revenues are exports. So if something happens in US or Europe, Balakrishna probably will get impacted. But it's a dream run from a 2 rupee stock to almost 2,400, 2,500. It's a dream run for the company.